Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic methods of determination of oxygen in organic compound. Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that how can we detect the percentage of the phosphorus that has been present in the organic compound, and based on that we have did a numerical also. And now we are going to do that, what are the methods that so as to we could determine that the percentage of oxygen that has been present in the organic compound. So let us talk about that. So now here we are going to discuss about what are the methods to determine the percentage of the oxygen that has been present in the organic compound. So let us talk about this one. So talking about the organic compound consists of, as you know, it consists of the carbon, hydrogen, and moreover it could consist of various elements like oxygen, sulfur, phosphorus. So now when we are basically dealing with the percentage of the oxygen atom that has been present in the organic compound, so we have to follow a particular chemical reaction, and from that particular chemical reaction we could be able to determine that what would be the percentage of the oxygen that has been present in the organic compound. So for that, suppose if we have the organic compound, so now the organic compound is heated in presence of the nitrogen gas so as to produce oxygen molecules plus other gaseous products. So this oxygen that has been liberated from the organic compound, it shows that the organic compound consists of the oxygen element. So if that organic compound wouldn't have consisted of the oxygen element, then this reaction wouldn't have been followed and we couldn't have got this oxygen molecule. So now when this oxygen is being obtained, so what we have to do is we have to pass this all gases through a red hot coke material, and from which we could see that the reaction with carbon and oxygen will take place in such a manner that the carbon monoxide will be produced. So therefore we could write it in this way, that is, when oxygen is now being treated with carbon, so therefore 2 moles of carbon will be reacted with oxygen so as to produce, that is, 2 moles of CO. So this is the product that we have got when it has been passed through, that is, red hot coke. So let this be equation 1. So here we have got that the carbon has reacted with the oxygen so as to produce, that is, carbon monoxide. But now this carbon monoxide that has been produced, it will be further reacted with, that is, iodine pentoxide, and then in that case basically the oxidation reaction would take place, and in that case basically the carbon monoxide will be converted into carbon dioxide. So let me give you that what would be the reaction in that case. So in that case basically carbon monoxide will react with iodine pentoxide so as to form, that is, carbon dioxide plus I2. But in this case we have to balance the reaction, so therefore for balancing the reaction we will multiply this by 5, and the rest of, even here it is 5 carbon atoms that have been in the reactant side, and here also there will be 5 carbon that will be in the reactant side, and everything is now been balanced. So now let us consider this equation as equation number 2. So this is the balanced reaction when a carbon monoxide has been treated with that is iodine pentoxide so as to form carbon dioxide, and iodine is the byproduct in this case. But if you compare the first one, that is the first reaction in which 2 moles of carbon monoxide has been produced. So since 2 moles of carbon monoxide has been produced and the same carbon monoxide is being passed through this I2O5, that is iodine pentoxide. So but if you see, the reaction is not balanced in terms of the carbon monoxide. So what we have to do is we have to balance the reaction in such a manner that even the moles of the carbon dioxide or the moles of the carbon monoxide that is being utilized so as to form 5 moles of carbon dioxide in this case, it would be equal to the amount of carbon monoxide that has been produced over here. So therefore I could do one thing, that is, I will multiply this equation by 5, and I'll multiply this equation by 2. So if I do this thing, then the first equation, that is the equation number 1 that I have written over here, so now this would be become, that is, 10 carbon plus 5 O2 so as to give, that is, 10 moles of carbon monoxide. Well, the same, even this equation is being multiplied by 2, so now in this case this would be turned into, that is, 10 moles of carbon monoxide plus 2 moles of I2O5, that would give us 10 moles of, that is CO2, and then further it will give us basically 2 moles of I2. So this is the reaction that I have maintained over here. So in this case I could clearly indicate that suppose if 10 moles of carbon has been utilizing 5 moles of carbon, 5 moles of oxygen, so as to produce 10 moles of carbon monoxide, and that 10 moles of carbon monoxide when reacted with I2O5, so as to form 10 moles of carbon dioxide, and I would write it over here as, that is 2 moles of I2. So this is the reaction that we have got over here, and in this case we have got to know ultimately that if we use 5 moles of O2, then only we will get, that is 10 moles of CO2, and that is the reason that if oxygen that has been produced from the organic compound and we have treated it with a flow of that is nitrogen gas, and we have heated it, so in that case the oxygen that would be evolved, that would be reacted with the carbon, and so as to produce basically ultimately it will produce 10 moles of CO2. So in this case we could say that if 5 moles of, that is O2, is able to produce, that is 10 moles of CO2, then we could easily say that is 1 mole of O2 will produce, that is 2 moles of CO2. So in this case we could write it in this manner also, because the molecular weight of carbon dioxide is basically 44 grams per mole when we calculate the molecular mass of the carbon dioxide. So therefore in this case, as we got to know, that is 2 moles of carbon dioxide is been produced when 1 mole of oxygen has been reacted, and talking about the molecular weight of the oxygen, then it is basically 32 gram per mole. So therefore we could easily say that is if 88 gram of that is carbon dioxide has been suppose it has been produced because of, that is if I take 1 mole of oxygen and oxygen gas, then it will be basically 32 gram of oxygen. So this is the thing that we have wrote over here. So now suppose, so this is the stoichiometry that we have did, and that is what we have got over here, that is 88 gram of carbon dioxide will be produced because of the 32 gram of oxygen has been used in that kind of reaction. So I could write it in this way, that is what if the I could say, suppose we consider the mass of the organic compound BM. So this is the mass of the organic compound that we have to, and on which we have to, and of a given mass, and for which we have to do the reaction, and so as to produce a particular mole of, or a particular mass of that is oxygen, and that will be treated with I2O5 so as to give you carbon dioxide. So as, so we could consider in this way also, that is suppose in that case, suppose if we have taken the organic compound as the weight of organic compound as M, and in that case suppose ultimately M1 gram of the carbon dioxide has been produced, so therefore I would write it over here. So suppose M1 be the mass of CO2 produced during the reaction. So therefore I could compare it with this one also, that is if suppose that is 88 gram of carbon dioxide produces for which it requires 32 gram of oxygen, then what we have got, we have got suppose M1 gram of the carbon dioxide. So suppose M1 gram of the carbon dioxide has been produced, so how much gram of the oxygen has been required in that case? So therefore what we are going to do is, we'll do a cross multiplication over here. So we could write it over in this way, therefore M1 gram of carbon dioxide will produce, so in a cross multiplication we would get, that is 32 multiplied by M1 divided by 88 gram of oxygen. So this is what we have got. So this is the thing that we have did, and suppose if we have 100 gram of the organic compound, so this is basically M1 gram, and it is not 100, it can be more or it could be less than 100. So what if we have received 100 gram of carbon dioxide? So therefore we could say that is, therefore 100 gram of carbon dioxide will produce, that is 32 into M1 divided by 88 into 100 gram of oxygen. So now suppose if we have to take the percentage, so therefore how can we take the percentage? And so in this case we could easily say that is, therefore the percentage of the oxygen that has been required or that has been produced during the reaction of the oxygen with the flow of the nitrogen, and we have heated that, so in that case basically the oxygen has been produced. So therefore in that case we could easily detect that is 32 into M1 into 100 divided by 88 into basically the because we are taking the percentage of the oxygen in the given organic compound, and the given organic compound has the mass of that is M. So now this is the thing that we have got over here, and this is how we could calculate the percentage of the oxygen that has been present in the organic compound. So this was the method to determine the oxygen that has been present in the organic compound. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you'll share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.